Hey, what's up? My name is Omi. It's a pleasure for me to tell you how I wrote the song, Cheerleader. It's about 7 years ago. I was in a taxi. I was developing my catalog at an underground studio, and I was in a taxi heading to the studio. And I had the melody in my head like early that morning. You know, I was working out the melody in my head, and it was so catchy, you know. And I was thinking, I used to love to write from a metaphoric standpoint. That was like my thing, you know. So that's how I came up with the metaphor cheerleader to mean, you know, that support system. So I had enough to go on, you know. By the time I get to the studio, the concept was already there, you know, and it was just for the lyrical composition. But I had an idea. I didn't want to put a beat underneath the song. The idea was for it to be an interlude on the on what would be an album eventually. So I finished writing the lyrics. It was only two verses because it was supposed to be short. I had the idea to use vocals to actually create like a beatbox technique. That's how that really came about. If you listen to the original, you can still hear there's not a live bass playing in there. That's actually a mouthpiece, man. You know, that's actually a beatbox technique. And you know, we recorded it. It was nice. It was, you know, sounding really creative, and I was pretty excited about it. When I met my manager, Clifton Specialist, Dylan, he said to me that this is a really interesting concept. This is like a hit song, you know, but I think we need to put a beat underneath it. And I was like, okay, you're the boss, you know, so let's do that then. You know, we linked up with Sly Dunbar from the popular duo Sly and Robbie, and Dean Fraser played horns on it. Sly played drums, you know, and we just, he was just like a mad scientist, you know, in the studio, and I watched him work, and you know, we put it together, and he said, you need to do a third verse, you know, and I was like, okay, I like the direction where it's going, so I wrote the third verse, you know, and we you know, put it together. He had it mixed, mastered, and it was out. And it had such a huge impact back in 2012 when it was originally released in Jamaica, Hawaii, you know, Dubai. You know, it was doing pretty well, that version. But we knew it had like the potential to do a lot more. And so when I was signed to Ultra back in 2013, the 28th of November, I remember the date and everything, man, it's weird. You know, they told me that they really loved the song. They were on board with the project. Felix Yen was also with Ultra. So they had him do a remix. Also a Ricky Blaze version, you know, and both were sent to us. You know, and for some reason, I really love the Ricky Blaze remix, but Felix Yen, like, took it from a whole different angle, you know, and he kept true to the essence of the song. And that's one of the things that I've always respected about it, you know. And you know, it was released, and I heard it started doing very well, you know, in Sweden. You know, it started going like three times platinum, four times platinum, five times, and I'm like, wow, this is amazing, you know. Took off in Europe, spread to other European countries, you know. It was also UK, you know, platinum certified, and Germany, Italy, you know, just to name a few. And eventually we're here in the US. It's like taking it from a whole different angle. So that's how that song came about. That's how I got to this point. And it was my pleasure to share.